Thanks for having us here today. Ras Maxi is the leader of the Rastafarian community in the Southern Cape and has a few more other titles that I can't remember. I've known him for a long time here in Knysna as a really great person who's fought hard for legalization and knows how to negotiate with the police. So we heard about your recent successes and we'll get to that later, but I thought perhaps you'd just like to introduce yourself first.
Oh, thanks Mary Lou, and even for the opportunity, and also thanks to Jah, because Jah is the word for God in our term as Rasta. But yeah, thank you again for the opportunity and also to share this. Yeah, my title, I don't want to call it a title, but I'm Ras Maxi. Ras is a title, Ethiopian title, that means head or chief or prince. So yes, and in the community itself, I was elected 1993 as chairperson of the House of Judah Rastafari community, which was based in Knysna. And then we took it a little bit further. We also established other houses in the Southern Cape. So I'm currently chairperson in the Rasta community from Plet to Swellendam, which is the southern part of South Africa.
We heard about your recent successes in getting your cannabis returned by the Uniondale police, and we're quite impressed with that bit of good news, and we'd love to find out a few things about that, how you managed that. And one of the questions we'd like to ask is, what rank policeman did you negotiate with?
Because of the outcome of September 18,
yes,
2018, mm-hmm. when I was at the court there with Jules, the late Jules, and Merle. And yes, Jules was a great friend, and I would also say he was also a great inspirator, because of that man, no matter color, he was the one boldly stand there. And as Rastas, we used to associate ourselves with people who was in line with us, especially when it comes to ganja, cannabis. Yeah, but anyhow, since the court outcome was like that was the basis of everything, because that was a court ruling. And then we were just taught over all these years, ganja was being taken, we was put into jail sometimes, we have to fight the case with lawyers, which means a lot of money. Mm. Sometimes we successful, sometimes not, we have to serve prison sentence. So we thought, no, I mean, the court at least give us that foundation. Our right is our right, and it will stay like that. We are ganja smokers, so if the court allows us to smoke.
Yes. How did you get that across to the Uniondale policeman?
Yeah, okay, the Uniondale was already, to say so, the third incident. Because the first was we were getting our ganja back from outside police.
Yes.
You know, the pops, those orange badges, the tough ones, we were getting back from them. And the basis was simply, if there's no court case, then mm-hmm. already it's a plus into your favor.
Mm-hmm.
There was no court case, so it's your property.
Mm-hmm.
It's your private property. So on that already, then you have a big, how can I say, chance, because the court wasn't seen as a case. But if there was a case, obviously you have to wait for the outcome, what did they say. But the court knows by now, they have to respect the constitutional court. They, if it is a certain amount, not big, it's your personal possession, and the court is not allowed to take it away. So I will simply say the police tried to make it just difficult for us, obviously, while we have the favor of the courts.
So you just reasoned that you had the courts were on your side?
That's straight, yeah, because of simple as that, what was the charge? Because there's no dealing, they didn't get them or find them dealing, there was this possession, so possession is in your favor.
Are they still regularly arresting your community?
Yes, since then a lot of
since
brothers.
Since 2018.
Yes, I mean there was a lot of brothers coming to us, and especially to Garrett, hey, what does this mean? And And we have to explain over and over, you see. It's firstly our privacy that is being, respected. It's not to say, yes, ganja is legal, because to say ganja is legal, to say sell it, get a benefit out of it. So far as personal possession in your privacy. So we still have a long way to go, but it's a start, you see. And now with the new law that is coming out, I mean, we are looking and we're seeing if we're not happy. I mean, we're there. What you call it.
Did they say anything? Did they show any sign, the police, that they understand that the law has changed, that their colleagues should learn that the law has changed? Are they admitting that they having difficulty accepting the new law, the police, in any
yes,
way?
Yes, definitely. Because of the older ones, you find them, they still stuck with the old mentality. And the younger ones, obviously, because some of them even might smoke.
Yeah.
They are more there or tolerant than whatever. Very keen to help out, but you find that the older ones, they are the ones that must rather be removed or be retrained.
The dinosaurs.
Because that's our big problem. They can't, because most of them work on their own, what you call it,
they're not going to change.
Discretion, if you call it that. Yes. And sometimes their discretion is only towards their own benefit and not towards the victim. So I think, that's where the problem lies, the old guys, you see. They can't see the change.
Do you find that some of police stations around here are worse than others?
I will say Knysna is not what we want yet, because why is it so? I went there for an attempt and it was not successful, and I asked them in my own place
why. An attempt to get it back.
In other places, which is not my place, the people understand why not here. So it seems like there's something else, because there's something that I think I still need to take it forward, whereby there was confiscate ganja, have the brother in court. When he appeared, no ganja case, he was rather being charged for assault, and he paid that because the assault came out of the ganja issue, but at the end there was no ganja issue. I went back and asked, where's the ganja, because they were, they said they destroyed. I asked them how. You can't destroy the ganja unless the court case is done, because they might ask it. So there's still something that I have to go check. And I went to the station commander and he said, no, but then I have to go to kitchen. And I go to captain kitchen and I end up there. I have like argue with the two of them. Hey, what's been destroyed? And the law is still not the law. I said, no, you have it wrong. And at the end they said, they did destroy it. I said, no. I will go to your station commander, Metu, and I told him, and I asked him, who is ruling the station? Because somebody still sent me up and down, and he said, okay, if I'm not happy, I must write a letter. Then I went to the state prosecutor, what's his name, Extian, or I don't know, but the new one there, and he also listened to me, said, no, but you're supposed to get it back if the court didn't have any rule. I said, but it is destroyed, so somebody take my ganja. So which means in my own place, Knysna, I still have something to sort out while I get it. In other places, Split was the second, Chunindale was the third, and there was just now last week again another situation in Chunindale, and it was so easy because of the previous one. They just gave it all 3 kilos. Yeah, that was now a week ago. So there was two times now in Chunindale. The previous one, and this one was even much easier, because it seems like there's a precedent to say, no, we can't keep our ganja.
A couple more questions. How many, when they arrest people, because they're continuing to arrest people, how many of these arrests do you feel end up with people actually in jail, in prison, or fined? Do they actually go through with it, or is it just thrown out in court?
Most of it, I will say 80% of cases is thrown out. It's because thrown out. It's mostly not that much. And the few that I heard, which was bigger amount, it's still pending. And it's not really Rasta, but they are still courting people.
And
that's the problem, because there's a law that is still must come out, so how can they be so bad? I mean, it's a grey area for them to be tolerant and see.
And when they arrest and confiscate the cannabis, do they have search warrants always, the police?
Most of these times it was like they're doing their duty. The last tour, Junindale, was on roadblocks. The Junindale tour was through roadblocks. The ones locally was mostly on duty. They just do their work, but they ended nowhere. It was no case. So it's a time waste.
I hope the sound is coming through properly on this video. Lastly, the draft cannabis bill. Have you had a chance to look at it? And do you think it will change anything about the way you do things?
No, I did have a look at it. And Garrett Prince also sent me the latest interview that he would have with the government regarding this. No, it's totally there. They don't consider really the society or the communities. Because I think that's one of the things, public participation. We that suffer the most, I think we didn't participate any in that bill. But yes, we know that we have things in place like all greens, that stuff, the Dagga couple, we work with them and give them some inputs. So which means we know with that little booklet that they have, if they really follow that, that's amazing. That's what they're supposed to do.
Yes.
It's a fair share. It's not like we take the whole cake.
Because
we know there need to be regulations and there's people out there that, are out of line. So we are considerate, but them, what they have right now, they're even jail sentences, that's out of the line. Still jail sentences connected to guns, and that's not the issue. So we're not happy really with what they have in mind for us. But still, it's a draft and it's up to us to really make the necessary changes that benefits us all.
Okay, great. Well, thanks very much, Maxi. That was a great interview. I hope the sound came out okay. We're going to have to listen to it now.
Thanks, Mary Lou and Bruce, again for the opportunity, because our voices need to be heard out there, because all the years we speak these things here, but people don't know it out there, so actually nothing is new. This thing of smoking in your privacy, we do it all the years and fight for it, so we stand now planting our plant. We planted all the years, you see, before this outcome, so just to show them we are on the right track. Now with this coronavirus also, this is the answer, you see. They don't believe it, but this is the magic plant, it's a miracle plant, it's a plant that will help us out of this economic problems and whatever, our health problems, justice problems. This is the answer.
God bless. God bless. Thanks.